And welcome back to Let's Play Pillars of Eternity. Blind, I'm the RPG chick. We are in the cave off of Searing Falls. I'm gonna try this again. This named Drake or Dragon laid waste to us. But we've gained 2 levels. And many useful abilities. So, once again, gonna send a dare forward.
Hey.
I guess there's no sense in us sneaking.
Yeah.
Hey. Of course.
The moment of truth, guys. Let's see if we can do this. Hello. Cail the Silent. You know, we've seen this all before. Spark. Almost I didn't come to take your spark. Cold, dirty paws. Run, Adair! Run! Back!
Hey.
Run, Adair! Aelas! What are you doing? Why did Aelas start running forward? I did not tell him to do anything like that.
Hi?
By the way, start off with Holy Radiance. Can't wait for them to come closer, right? Can I affect them with this yet? Rhinegrim's innervating terror. I gotta wait for them to take their place. I'm not sure if they move, it's just gonna hit here, where they used to be. While I'm waiting for them to do that, I'll just hit them with a concussive missile. Do we have to move forward to get this ringleader? Or is there to ringleader the Zorb champion? Hopefully she can cast it from here. Other than that, these guys have to wait. Okay. Freaky. Okay, we can go now with this. Innervating terror. I'm not sure. She might have to get closer for this. Canna! Where are you going? Yes, my ass. Interdiction. Daze your foes. I don't think she can cast that far with that. Range 5 meters. Yeah, that's nothing. How about this one? 4 meters. It's not gonna do it. 10 meters. How about soul ignition on this thing? Did I cast that? Interdiction? Okay. Armor of Faith. Suppress Affliction from the Paladin. Where is he? There, knock him down again.
Hey.
That's not.
Pause. Now, since they're both attacking this together, he gets a 10% to hit or something like that. Pretty sure it's a passive effect. Blessing.
Very helpful.
Oh, right. I haven't given you anything useful to do, have I? I don't think flame's gonna hurt very much, so Noxious Burst. That'll do it. The young Drake is near death. Awesome. Heal her. Still terrified, weakened, sickened, awesome. For another 10 seconds, I can cast it again. So for right now, though, concussive missile on the Zora Pipe Priest, since this thing's almost dead. One priest down, one Drake down. Guessing it's undamaged. Knock him down. Should probably save the knockdowns for the big guy, but what am I gonna do? So terrified and weakened, okay. So I'm gonna do another concussive missile. Yeah, burning isn't gonna do much, so. Crush damage and knockdown. What's his range on that, actually? 10 meters?
I'm ready.
I decided to do nothing at this point. Oh, we're all frightened again. Okay, let's do this again. Suppress Affliction. Paladin comes in handy, I'll tell you. Mine blades off of this drake.
That's not very helpful.
Okay, their thing wore out, so... One more time with the innovating terror. I think it helps. Seems to help. Okay, I guess our shield wore out. Blessing. We still have armor of faith. Blessing, okay. She's out of focus, unfortunately. Well, we can switch to ranged. Get some focus back that way. Oh, that's not even her. Duh. Pull her faith, why not? We're doing well. If you can reach. Down. Boom. Is that what he called? No, it's clear out. I guess he can't reach. You know, Palagina?
What?
You heard me. Guess again.
Oh,
you are both attacking it, right? Just want to make sure. And where's Aloth? I mean, Adair. Nah, Canna. Can you get through?
Nah, nah.
You can't get through, yeah, Kana. Lamer, you're supposed to be hanging out on the front lines and you ran out. You can just shoot him, I guess. Better than that. Hey, we killed that one, right? Cail the Silent, and that's a dead one underneath. Okay, it was a little confusing. Clear out again. Concussive missile. At least you got focus back. Soul ignition.
I'm ready.
Owie? Alright, lay on hands. Giving our cleric enough to do. She's out of focus again. Here. Another concussive missile. Almost dead. Let me hit the Cail the Silent. Yeah. Hey, is that it? Hey, hey. I wonder if Canna could fit through if they move forward a little.
Hey.
Yeah. I'm not sure what Durin's doing. Let Arcana through. Durance.
Following your lead.
You're trying to follow my lead. Noxious Burst. Alright, I don't know how much he is because he went into his thing, so just throw him a heal. Actually, Theodos can run up and attack. Can you get through, Theodos? Can you go over there? She can't go over there. Never mind. Just necrotic lance. Pillar of Faith, trying to go all out here.
Yes.
Pour in another heal for these two. Kinda. At least they're all together, that's great. Grab Lance. I forgot about this missile. Bounding missile. Badly injured. He missed. Huh. I didn't think we could miss with that. I thought that was guaranteed a hit with those. One more time. Another pillar of faith.
Lavaru.
Near death. Hooray. One more pillar of faith. We still got this. We got two more heals out of there. We've got other light heals, so it's all right. It's near death.
How may I help?
Lavaru, beyond seek.
Lavaru, beyond seek.
Awesome! Yay! Wow, that was one hell of a battle. Definitely a lot easier than the first time. Opal, Valoon, Peridot, Tongues, Drake Talons, a burning stone. A bright orange light blazes from the center of the stone. It radiates intense heat, yet it doesn't burn your hands as you hold it. Okay. On the ground where the dragon had curled around it, you find a stone that glows a brilliant orange, yet it is cool to the touch when you reach to retrieve it. Durance catches a glimpse of it, and his eyes bulge out of their sockets. He scowls, his mouth puckered as though having tasted poison, and he spits on the stony ground. A whore's cruel jest. The bitch has always known where to sink her claws to get a rise out of me. We gained a lot of experience. What do you mean? This stone you carry. This is part of the bomb that destroyed Aethys, the Godhammer. What's it doing here? One wonders. The bomb blew big, but it would not have sent fragments this far from the citadel. The Drake must have carried it quite a distance, or Magrin merely put it here herself. You seem angry. For the first time, Durrance seems to become aware of his demeanor, and as quickly as it had flared, it seems to recede, until you start to question whether he had been angry at all. Hmm? No, it is not anger, you see. I am merely the victim of a divine practical joke, it seems, that will remain between she and I, Watcher, for only I am able to appreciate it. I think we've asked him this before, but, tell me about the Godhammer. Ask me on the road, Watcher. I'm in no mood for it with the whore's bitter perfume still clogging my senses. Is it worth anything? Ha! Ask Aethys. If you mean in terms of copper, there was a time when it might have been, but the market soon became flooded with pieces of the Godhammer, most of them no more than the trivial enchantment of swindlers dabbling in wizardry. Counterfeit. As there has never been a reliable way to judge a fragment's authenticity, and the would-be judges are often watchers, questionable as the artifacts themselves, their value has plummeted considerably. Ask any shopkeeper if he's interested, and he'll try to sell you his fragments instead. Let's bring it back to Frigga. You catch Durrance scowling once more at the corner of your eye, but he says nothing else. Frigga was correct in both of her predictions. I found a strange glowing stone and a massive drake guarding it. The beast seemed almost reverent of this spark. Durrance explained that the glowing stone is actually a fragment of the Godhammer bomb, a powerful weapon that was built with Magrin's divine aid. I could see why Frigga would find this meaningful. Well, not Frigga, I keep calling her. Minor adventure completed. Yay! I've yet to check out the Great Hall treasury chest.
Be cautious. Be constant.
Hmm. I think we looked at that from over there. Stuff. So they've added sounds, definitely. Ooh, there's something here too. Ooh, trapped.
See now what the flame has shown us?
Yes, a trap.
What?
Ooh, we found something else here too.
Something over there.
Yeah, just disarm that. We'll look at that too. A ruby? Ooh. Andra Tara? Opal? 23 gold. Translate as Andra's Tooth. These are large Baroque teardrop-shaped pearls, most commonly found and traded by Omawa. Hmm. Not sure if you've ever seen that.
Following your lead.
Tidefall. Unique great sword. Two-handed. 20% of damage restored as endurance. 25% damage inflicted over time. Superb. Plus 12 accuracy. Plus 45% damage. A Ra'atai harbormaster, tired of officiating disputes between the various sailors, merchants, and pirates that daily made use of his port. The rowdy visitors caused trouble with the locals and with each other, leaving the harbormaster forever cleaning up their messes. He was large, even for an Amawa, but soft-spoken, so he commissioned a local smith to forge the kind of sword that would do the talking for him. He took to patrolling the docks with it, relying on his own towering presence and his formidable blade to silence most arguments. He issued a mandate that any visiting sailors at port that did not conduct their business peacefully and depart with the tides would find themselves subject to his own mercenary justice. Disagreements were settled quickly and quietly after that. Quickly and quietly. I'm not sure. I think our paladin uses a great sword. He uses an S stock. Yes. Before and after. Well, it does much better slashing damage. Damage restored is endurance. Damage inflicted over time. Can we enchant anything? No. We can do Burning Lash. Now, Tidefall it is.
Right away.
Yeah.
Some more stuffs. Rippling waves of heat rise. They certainly do. Ooh, Girdle of the Driving Wave. Escroll of Boiling Spray. Potion of Power and Opal. I believe Adair has a few potions of power. Boiling Spray. Everyone in the cone area of effect takes burn damage and is pushed back. 40 to 50 burn. 2 meter push versus reflex. Makes sense you'd find something like that here. And the Girdle of the Driving Wave. Grants knockdown, one per encounter. This belt, etched with cresting waves, carries a powerful enchantment which allows the wearer to send out a burst of arcane force in a circle around themselves. The burst hits foes like a crashing wave, often taking them off their feet. Nice. She has mortal protection. Minus 27 crit damage taken. Aeloth has it too. None of the rest of us have any, Yeah, let's give it to Canna. Well, Canna can knock down someone sometimes. Is it once per rest or once per battle? Would I give it to? It's so hard to find stuff sometimes. Here it is. Cool. Clunk. Potion of power. So that's it. Gotta get the hell out of here. We did it! Hooray! So. Do we just run this way quickest? Back to Cleobon Relark, because now we can get past that door, I bet. Not tired yet? Good. What is that? We can't go that way. Okay, just making sure. That's the door we couldn't open.
Time to see and not be seen.
Hmm?
We can do it without any lockpicks. Especially because he's got this on. Plus two mechanics. I forgot, I thought it was plus one.
I can do that.
You sure can,
that's
my friend.
That's settled.
Okay, guys. See you next time. Thanks for watching. See you next episode when we finally get in here. And let's see. If we finish it this episode, we'll be heading back to report to the Lady Web. And we'll be reporting to What's-Her-Name about what we found just before in the Searing Falls Cave. So thanks for watching. See you then. And endure. In enduring, grow strong.